Hello students, so in previous class I discussed about the Bayesian learning and the important features of the Bayesian learning methods. I hope the concepts are clear. So in today's class that I am going to discuss the Bayes theorem, which is also an important theorem here. So Bayes theorem, definitely there may be a question in your examination about the Bayes theorem, and also the concept of Bayes theorem that you need to study with respect to some formulas or the derivation kind of things, right? So in machine learning, as we are openly interested in determining the best hypothesis from the space H is nothing but the set of hypothesis that we know, right? Given the observed training data capital T, as of course this is what an important objective here. So usually in machine learning we are openly interested in determining the best hypothesis from the space H, that is hypothesis space H, given the observed training data, right? So one way to specify what we mean by the best hypothesis is to say that we demand the most probable hypothesis given the data D plus any initial knowledge about the prior probabilities of the various hypotheses in the hypothesis space H. So Bayes theorem provides a direct method for calculating such probabilities that we know already. So more precisely, the Bayes theorem provides a way to calculate the probability of a hypothesis which is based on its prior probability and the probabilities of the observing various data given the hypothesis and the observed data itself, right? So to define the Bayes theorem precisely, let us first introduce little notations. So you need to understand some of the notations here. So first is we shall write P of H. This is first notation. So this notation is to denote the initial probability that hypothesis H holds before we have observed the training data. That is the notation P of H. Then the next notation is P of D. Of course, P of H is clear. So P of H is known as prior probability of H. So this notation is used to denote the initial probability that hypothesis H holds before we have observed the training data. So this notation is called as prior probability of H, and it may reflect any background knowledge that we have about the chance that H is the correct hypothesis. Here, if we have no such prior knowledge, then we might simply assign same prior probabilities to each candidate hypothesis. Similarly, the next notation that we shall write is a P of D. So P of D is to denote the prior probability that the training data D will be observed. So next notation is P of D bar H. So this notation is to denote the probability of observing data D given some world in which hypothesis H holds. So more generally, we can write it as P of X bar Y. So which is to denote the probability of X given Y. So in machine learning problems, we are interested in the probability P of H bar D, that is the last notation, so that H holds given the observed training data D. Here P of H bar D is called as a posterior probability of H. So P of H is known as prior probability of H, whereas P of H bar D is known as posterior probability of H, because it reflects our confidence that H holds after we have seen the training data D. Here you can notice that the posterior probability, that is P of H bar D, it reflect the influence of the training data D in contrast to the prior probability P of H, which is independent of D. P of H is independent of D, right? I hope these notations are clear. P of H, which is known as the prior probability of H, P of D is prior probability of D, and P of D bar H is the probability of the observing data D in which H holds, and last is P of H bar D, which is the posterior probability of H that reflect the confidence that H holds after the data D has been observed. So these are what an important notations in the Bayes theorem. Here Bayes theorem is one of the cornerstone, you can see. Our Bayes theorem is the fundamental of the Bayes learning methods, because it provides a way to calculate the posterior probability, that is P of H bar D, from the prior probability P of H together with P of D and P of D bar H. So Bayes theorem is represented in terms of this formula, that is P of H bar D is equal to P of D bar H into P of H divided by P of D. So P is nothing but the probability. So this is what the representation of Bayes theorem, that is Bayes theorem. P of H bar D is equal to P of D bar H into P of H whole divided by P of D. So as one might intentionally expect that P of H bar D increases with P of H and with P of D bar H according to the Bayes theorem, and it is also reasonable to see that P of H bar D decreases as P of D increases, because they are inversely proportional, because the more probable it is that D will be observed independent of H. Here the less evident D provides in support of H. I hope Bayes theorem representation is clear, and how exactly P of H bar D and P of H bar D, that is P of H bar D increases and P of H bar D decreases with respect to these components. Here in many of the learning scenarios, the learner consider some set of candidate hypothesis H and is interested in finding the most probable hypothesis, that is a small h, which is belonging to the capital H. Of course, hypothesis is always belonging to the hypothesis space, right? Given the observed data D. Here, any such maximally probable hypothesis, which is known as the maximum posterior hypothesis, MAP in short, you can call it as, means any maximally probable hypothesis is known as a maximum posterior hypothesis, that is MAP hypothesis. So we can determine the MAP hypothesis by using the Bayes theorem to calculate the posterior probability of each candidate hypothesis. More precisely, we'll say that H map, so this notation, right? So this H map, right? So this H map is the map hypothesis. So the representation of map hypothesis is H map. So it is a map hypothesis which is provided, and the representation of H map is given here, that is H map is equal to arg max P of H bar D, where H belongs to H, which is equal to arg max P of D bar H into P of H divided by P of D, where H belongs to capital H, that is the hypothesis belong to the hypothesis space, and it is simplified as arg max P of D bar H into P of H, where H belongs to capital H. Here we can notice that in the final step that we have dropped the term p of d because it is a constant which is independent of h. So as p of d is independent of h, so we are dropping this term, and finally we will get the h map as argmax p of d bar h into p of h, where small h belongs to the hypothesis space capital H. In the some cases, we will assume that every hypothesis in capital H is equally probable, that prior P of HI is equal to P of HJ for all HI and HJ in the capital H. So in this case, we can further simplify this previous equation, means this particular equation, will further simplify and need only the considered term, that is the P of D bar H, to find the most probable hypothesis. Here P of D bar H is openly called as the likelihood of the data D given H, and any hypothesis that maximizes P of D bar H is called as the maximum likelihood hypothesis, that is HML, maximum likelihood hypothesis. And this HML is given as HML is equal to argmax P of D bar H, where small h belongs to the hypothesis space capital H. Here, in order to make clear the connection to the machine learning problems, we introduce the Bayes' theorem above by referring to the data D as the training examples of some target function, and it is referring to capital H as the space of candidate target functions. In fact, the Bayes' theorem is much more general than suggested by this discussion, whatever that I have discussed. So it can be applied equally well to any set H of manually exclusive propositions whose probability sum to 1. So in this chapter or in this particular module, we'll at some times considering the cases where capital H is the hypothesis space containing the possible target functions and the data D that are the training examples. At the other times or in the other discussions, we'll consider the cases where H is some other set of manually exclusive propositions and capital D is some other kind of data. Now consider an example. So this to illustrate the Bayes' rule, consider a medical diagnosis problem in which there are two alternative hypotheses. One is the patient has a particular form of cancer, and second one is that a patient does not have the cancer, right? Here the available data is from a particular laboratory test with two possible outcomes. One is positive, that is a plus, and one more is the negative, that is minus. So we have the prior knowledge that over the entire population of the people, only 0.008 have this disease. Further, the lab test is only an imperfect indicator of the disease, and the test returns a correct positive result in only 98% of the cases in which the disease is actually present, and a correct negative result in only 97% of the cases in which the disease is not present. So in other cases, the test returns the opposite result. So the above situation can be summarized by this following probabilities: P of cancer equal to 0.008, and the other case is the 0.992. The chances of positive is 0.98, chances of negative is 0.02. Similarly, if the chances of positive is 0.03, then the chances of negative is 0.97. Of course, these are what the normal probabilities, right? Suppose we now observe a new patient for whom the lab test returns a positive result. So should we diagnose the patient as having the cancer or not? That is what the question in front of us. So the maximum posterior hypothesis can be found using the previous equation, right? So accordingly, the probabilities are P of chances of positive cancer into P of cancer is equal to 0.98 into 0.008. It comes out around 0.0078. In second case, that is negation cancer. So this particular case, the other case, there is no chances of cancer. So with respect to that, the probability comes around 0.0298. So in that case, HMAP is equal to negation cancer. That is what our ultimate result is. Here, the exact posterior probability can also be determined by normalizing the above quantities so that they sum to 1. So this step is warranted because the Bayes theorem states that the posterior probabilities that are just above the quantities divided by the probability of the data, that is P of plus. Although P of plus was not provided directly as a part of the problem statement, but we can calculate it in this fashion because we know that P of cancer bar positive and P of negation cancer bar positive must sum to 1. Of course, always they should be, because as you know, the summation of probabilities is always 1, right? So we can notice that while the posterior probability of the cancer is significantly higher than its prior probability, and the most probable hypothesis is still that the patient does not have the cancer. So as this example illustrated, that the result of Bayesian inference depends strongly on the prior probabilities which must be available in order to apply the method directly. So you can also note that in this example, the hypotheses are not completely accepted or rejected, but rather become more or less probable as more data is out. So this is what my today discussion is. So in the next class, that I am going to discuss Bayes theorem and the concept learning. Thank you.